I'm Ignacio Fernandez Llorente. Welcome to Polo Inn. In this video, we're going to have a look on how to mark at a knock-in. Most of the times, the player marking the opponent knocking in is number one. There are basically two ways in which you can mark the player knocking in. The first way is waiting for him on your back, as in this first example. The second way is waiting for him frontside. The advantage of marking the player knocking in, showing your back to him, is that you're ready to defend and to go in the direction in which he is knocking in. The main objective of the marking player is not to have the player knocking in escape. He wants the player to hit the ball as fast as possible. This kind of marking influences the direction of the knock-in, doesn't really put pressure on the player knocking in. Here we can see the white player who is giving his back to the player knocking in, and then he's ready to defend and gets into the game. Here again, the white player in the green circle is ready to defend. This is the ideal way of defending when there's a knock-in, if the player knocking in is better than the player marking. Watch out for the movement of the light blue player in this first example. So the light blue player, just by his position, influences the direction of the knock-in, because the player knocking him will not want to hit the ball towards his opponent's horse. Here again, the light blue player is in the way of the knock-in, and the blue player can only hit the ball towards the right of the field. This kind of marking doesn't really put pressure on the player knocking in, as in this case, the player knocking in can hit the ball without any pressure. Once again, the blue player prepares his swing and hits the ball without being disturbed. His opponent is waiting for him, giving him his back. And once again, the green player just wants the gray player to hit the ball forward. He's not pretending to pressure him. He doesn't even get close to him in the first place. Here the white player hits the ball totally free of marking, while the green player is waiting for him. Here the white player hits the ball with a close marking from the light blue player, influencing the direction of his knocking. It's ideal that the white player hits the ball as soon as possible, especially if he's better than the light blue player. Here the light blue player gets very close to the white player trying to mark him. He provokes him, and as the white player is a much better player than him, he escapes on the left hand side. This is now a big problem for the light blue players. It would have been better that the white player just hit the ball to the right. So now let's see another way of marking. Front side. Marking front side is more intimidating for the player knocking in. It stresses him out more, and it's a way of stealing the ball. Whenever it works or it doesn't work, it will provoke an attack or a defense. The negative side of it, the player coming in, if he misses, will be very slow to come back to defend. Plus, he won't be in the direction of defending, he has to turn around. So this is not a good point for his team. Let's see how it generates pressure on the ball handler. In this first example, a regular marking with the opponent waiting for the player knocking in, giving him his back. In this second case, the intimidation of the light blue player coming in front results in a bad pass. This is the big advantage of waiting the player knocking in frontside. Let's see with more detail. The player knocking in looks at the ball, and as soon as he hits a small auto pass, he sees the light blue player coming in to defend and to put pressure on him. He has to look at the ball again because he wants to hit it, and for a few seconds he doesn't see what the light blue player is doing. He gets stressed out and he misses his swing. These few seconds where the ball handler doesn't know what's the opponent is doing makes him nervous. If a player marks his opponent frontside on a knock-in, it will generate some pressure on him. Here the light blue player doesn't know what the white opponent will be doing and badly hits the ball. The red player puts pressure on the player knocking in. The result is a bad knock-in. Here the green player, just having a gray player on the right, makes him nervous. and he loses the ball. Marking the knocking in player front side is best if you have the same level or you're better than him. Here the blue player is chasing the red player. He wants the ball and he ends up getting it because he puts pressure on him. Marking front side permits you to get directly the ball in front of the opponent's goal. Here the grey player is going very smoothly and he loses the ball. Here the red player comes in front side and takes the ball. And look at the red player here. His horse stops for a tenth of a second and the blue player steals the ball away from him. Look at the black player now in front. He needs to turn around to defend and he is slow, of course. This is one of the problems of trying to steal the ball front side. Here the red player tries to steal the ball front side and he is very slow, of course, to turn around and defend. Here the red player tries to defend front side, the white player escapes, he's late, and then there's another red player coming in and taking the ball handler. Great marking from the red team. I hope you enjoy Poloin videos. Do not forget to click like. We are here to help and argument the game, to help more people to understand and play Polo. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Poloin is often updated. There are many new videos. You shouldn't miss any of them. Thank you very much and see you in the next video.